Good day, everybody. Welcome once again to the channel. Ano ang ating topic today? No? Ay all about deferred tax assets and deferred tax liabilities. This is under the financial accounting reporting subject, and we will just discuss this as brief as we can para lang ma-clear up natin kung ano talaga ang treatment para sa deferred tax assets and deferred tax liabilities. Ano? We also intend to give light to the taxable temporary differences and also the deductible temporary differences. Okay, so as quick as we can, ibibigay natin yung paliwanag dito, no? We intend to make it in a tagless version para ang students natin, ano, in accountancy, mas maiintindihan nila. Okay, so kailan ba to nangyayari, or in what instances this situation, no, are present sa ating accounting. Okay, so syempre tayo ay nag de-declare ng ating taxable income, no? In this case, meron tayong dalawang klaseng income, no? Tayo, alam natin, gumagawa tayo ng income statement. Merong lumalabas doon na when we are finished preparing the income statement, so we ended up with net income, no? So meron tayo tinatawag doon na taxable net income as far as the financial accounting is concerned, or the yung books natin, yung libro ng kumpanya, no? Meron tayo doon taxable income per books, no? And I would like to say merong differences yan as far as yung atin namang taxable income that is really intended for tax purposes, ano, for our BIR, no? Ganito yan. There are cases na mas mataas ang declared ng ano ng ating books, no? At again, to clear that up, pag mataas ang ating declared income sa books compared sa ating income, no, for tax purposes, no, that would result into a taxable temporary differences, and eventually ang ating napuproduce dyan ay ang deferred tax liability. So para mas malinaw, ito yung mga cases, no, na mas mataas ang deklarasyon ng income because merong mga income na nare-recognize ng libro but not yet, no, to the books, yung tinatawag to the income tax purposes, no? Sinasabi natin na temporary differences because before all of this, meron talaga tayong tinatawag na permanent differences. Yung bang mga income na recognize na libro pero hindi naman siya taxable, no, ng Philippine BIR. Katulad halimbawa nung mga interest on bank deposit, no. Sa ating libro, ni-recognize natin siya as interest income. Pero as far as our BIR is concerned, hindi na siya dapat isama sa income statement. Bakit? Subject na yan sa final tax. So, that's one sample na pwede lang nating sabihin, ano. Or maybe meron tayong declared income, no, in whatever manner. Pero hindi pa siya nire-recognize sa income for tax purposes. When we say hindi pa, that means to say timing ang pinag-uusapan dito, timing difference compared doon sa ating permanent difference, no, permanent differences. Kasi yung ibig sabihin ng permanent, talagang hindi na yan allowed kung deduction siya at hindi rin naman siya taxable kung siya naman ay income. Yun ang mga permanent differences. So, to go back dito sa taxable temporary differences, again, ito yung mga dineclare for this current year, dineclare natin as income but not yet to the taxable income, no? Katulad halimbawa ng yung payment in advance, no, sa isang service. But in your books, you declare that or you recognize that as prepaid. No, in accounting, we call that prepaid. It is not yet considered as expense. Siya ay asset pa lamang. But in the case sa income, no, for tax purposes, or shall we say taxable income, since siya ay kinonsider na ng BIR as deduction. Why? Because whatever we pay, no, whatever we pay for a certain cost, no, binayaran, is already a deductible, no, as long as it is allowed, no, it is considered as deduction. So that made the declared income as far as taxable income is concerned, mas mababa ang taxable income kasi na-consider na siya na expense kasi binayaran natin. Pero sa libro, yung payment natin, na-declare natin na prepaid, hindi pa siya natin ibinawas as expense because it is still an asset. So, whatever portion na-declared natin as prepaid is not yet a deduction on the financial accounting. So, anong tendency? Mas mataas ang income sa libro kaysa sa taxable income natin for BIR. Okay? So, yun ang nagsinasabi na taxable temporary difference. Why? Because in the coming year, no, when time comes na we already declared that as expense, no, that's the time naman yung BIR will no longer recognize that in the next year. So, ang case nito, no, ay on the first year we declared, no, a higher income tax because mataas ang base ng ating rate, no, tax rate, kasi mataas ang tinadeklara nating income, no. Tingnan niyo ang case, mababa ang expense kasi nga naging prepaid, mataas ang income. Kung mataas ang income, mataas ang ating income tax. But for tax purposes, no, for the BIR, since na-declare na siya na expense, mababa ang income and then mababa rin ang tax. So, in that case, since ang libro natin ay ating ina-update, no, ang ating income tax for this current year ay mas mataas. In this manner, we will have a two-section ng ating income tax, yung tinatawag na current income tax. Yun yung tax based sa ni-recognize ng BIR, no, yung mas mababang income tax. Plus, yun namang dineclare naman natin, no, na mas mataas na income, yung difference noon, no, yun ang tinatawag na taxable temporary difference, magiging deferred tax liability natin yun dahil mas mataas ang ating na-recognize na income tax, pero sisingilin tayo this year ng BIR ng mas mababa. But we will recognize yung difference as our liability. Bakit? Kasi in the coming year, no, that's the time na maniningil na at i-recognize na ng BIR yung income, because we will no longer allowed to claim that particular expense, no? Kasi this year ni-recognize ng BIR yung total deduction. And in the coming year, when we are to recognize that prepaid into expense, hindi na siya allowed. Kaya mas mataas na ngayon, no, yun yung reversal ng nung tinatawag na income, no, magre-reverse, no, kasi i-claim na natin siya as deduction, ina-claim na siya ng BIR nung first year, kaya nare-reverse na yung income. So, since na meron tayong deferred tax liability, which is we recognize our liability for the coming year, all we have to do is to pay. And makakancel na ngayon yung liability. That's the case sa ating temporary or taxable temporary difference. Again, the case is, the current year, mataas ang ating income compared sa taxable income, no? At on the coming year, since marireverse yun, i-claim na natin yung ating expense at hindi na siya allow ng BIR, mas mataas naman ngayon yung recognized income for tax purposes compared naman sa financial income. Kaya ang remedy, or hindi remedy, ano, this is the correct accounting for income taxation, magpuproduce or mag-create tayo ng deferred tax liability so that we are recognizing our obligation for the coming year, because sisingilin na nga tayo ng BIR, babayaran natin siya, no? Although we no longer declare that as income, kasi na-declare na nga natin siya on the first year. So, nag-re-reverse yun. Okay? So, in this session na mayroon tayong sample problem, I hope na makiklear this issue, no? Itong issue na ito ay makiklear siya sa ating mga isip, paano ang gagawin at paano siya na execute yung ating deferred tax liability. Okay, the next one, deductible temporary differences naman. Ito naman yung case wherein mas mataas naman yung taxable income compared sa financial income, no? Magbibigay lang tayo ng mga sample na instance, no? Because there are more than one sample for this scenario. Ang isang sample sa deductible temporary difference is that we already considered an expense, no, as a deduction sa ating financial income, wherein sa taxable income naman is not yet, no, not yet considered. Like in this case, merong mga estimated warranty liabilities, no? These warranty liabilities are recognized as expenses already, samantalang no payment has been made yet, no? And expectation natin dan expected is this will be materialize in the next year, but it is already recognized in the books as expense, no? Yung mga estimated warranty liabilities is one of the sample. But in the case of taxable income, hindi pa siya nire-recognize as a deduction, no? It will only be recognized as a deduction kung siya ay babayaran na ng company. So, mas mataas ngayon ang income recognized sa taxable income for tax purposes. So, baliktad naman ito, no? Ang kaso naman dito, you will pay more doon sa iyong declared na income tax payable for financial accounting, no? But you will pay more because mas mataas ang sisingilin sa iyo ng BIR, eh, no? Kasi ang warranty liability, no, that is an expense on that particular case. Kaya ibinawas na ng libro, mababa ang kanyang declared income. But in the side ng BIR, hindi pa niya re-recognize na deduction yon, kasi hindi pa siya actual payment. So, again, ang income tax payable ng libro ay mas mababa kaysa doon naman sa compared sa BIR income tax, mas mataas ang kanilang charges sa atin. So, ang magiging setup sa libro, no, ang income tax payable natin mababa. But we have another payment to be made, no? Just as similar doon sa prepayments, no? Kaya nga naging asset siya. Magbabayad tayo because sisingilin tayo ng BIR na mas mataas, eh. Pero hindi natin siya kikilalanin lahat na shall we say expense, kasi hindi pa natin siya declared na income tax. Kaya yung sobrang babayaran natin this year ay magiging asset natin. Yun yung tinatawag na deferred tax asset. Hindi siya natin kinilalang income tax, no, for our books. Pero magbabayad tayo dahil mataas ang sisingilin ng BIR sa atin. So, yan naman ang kaso ng deductible temporary difference. Bakit deductible? Because ang mangyayari on the next year, no, on the next year wherein na i-deduct na siya, no, ang ating ngayong income, no, on the coming year, no, as far as deductible temporary difference is concerned, no, ay mas mataas na basing only on that particular accounts, no, assuming everything is equal but the deductible temporary difference is concerned, magre-reverse na yan next year. Next year, wala ka nang i-recognize na expense kasi na-recognize mo na this year. Pero, since it will materialize or babayaran natin as far as nag-materialize yung mga estimated liability, warranty liability, may mga binayaran tayo, that's when the time, i-recognize ngayon niya ng BIR, no, that will tend to lower down your taxable income. But in your books, no, is It's just an ordinary payment, reversal of liability lang. Hindi nakaapekto sa ating income to lower down kasi nga na-deduct na natin siya this year. Kaya kahit magbayad tayo sa next year, no, kinakancel lang natin liability, pero sa BIR, no, kinoconsider 'yon na deduction kaya lumiliit ang taxable income as far as BIR, nare-reverse na ngayon. No? So, that's why ang tawag doon ay deductible, no? Deductible. No, madi-deduct siya on the coming year, no, as a deduction of income on the part naman ng BIR, no. Yun ang kaya siya nagiging deductible. So, kasi ang magiging scenario is we will produce, no, a higher, or shall we say declare a higher income, no, as a reversal dito sa unang taon, pero deductible considering na mababa lang yung sisingilin sa atin ng BIR kasi nga recognize niya na yung actual payment natin. So it's quite complicated, pero in a correct analysis and in a proper setting up ng mga accounts, it will be a clearer view on how to interpret and execute this accounting as far as income tax is concerned. So let's have an illustrative problem here, no, to demonstrate these two scenarios of taxable temporary difference and deductible temporary difference. Okay, this is the problem. Okay, Lecture Company reported the following selected information for the current year. No, accounting income tax, or rather accounting income before tax is 9.7 million. Interest income on tax exempt municipal bonds is 300,000. Depreciation claim on the tax return in excess of financial depreciation 500,000. Carrying amount of depreciable asset in excess of tax basis 800,000. Warranty expense reported on the income statement 200,000, but the actual warranty expenditure is 50,000 and the income tax rate is 30,000. At the beginning of the year, no, sabi, the entity reported deferred tax asset at zero and a deferred tax liability of 90,000. So there are series of questions here, no. So we will end the problem at that. Okay, just we will have to give you an analysis of the problem that is given. Okay, ganito yan. Ang accounting income before tax. So ito yung product ng ating bookkeeping and accounting. 9.7 million ang lumabas sa ating income statement. That is before any adjustment. Okay, number one, is it included talaga or hindi? Yung interest income on tax-exempt municipal bonds, no? Part yan nung 9.7. So, question. So, ito ba ay okay for tax purposes, or is it an adjustment, or shall we say temporary difference, or not? So, we will clear that up. Okay, interest income on tax-exempt municipal bonds are what we call permanent temporary difference. No, for tax purposes, hindi talaga siya isasali, no? For financial accounting kasi, all the income and expense are recognized. Pero for tax purposes, ito, if we will look at the income tax rules, hindi ito dapat isali sa income statement kasi these are subject to final taxes already. Kaya hindi siya part ng taxable income natin kasi yan ay na-subject na sa final tax, kung taxable, but in this case, since this is a municipal bond, no, just to clear that up, this is a municipal bond which is tax exempt. So, even the BIR and the tax authority will not consider that as taxable, tax exempt ka, because we, the government cannot tax itself, no? Kasi yan ay transaction with the government, no? Kaya siya ay permanent differences, no? Kaya dapat siyang i-exclude, no, for tax purposes. Inuulit ko, this is a tax exempt bonds, so the income from these bonds are not taxable, so exclude talaga natin siya, permanent difference siya, and it will not give rise to any differences, no, hindi siya difference eh, kasi totally siya ay dapat i-exclude, no? I hope the explanation is correct. Okay, next. Depreciation, claim on tax return in excess of financial depreciation. So, ang kaso rito, mas malaki ang kinlaim ng for tax purposes, mas malaki ang kinlaim ng deduction kumpara sa financial income, no? Ang ibig sabihin, kung mas malaki ang kinlaim for tax purposes na depreciation, mas maliit ang income na ni-recognize niya for tax purposes ng 500. Okay? So, ano ang case o ano ang tinatawag natin na category nung itong 500,000 na to? So, that is a taxable temporary difference. Why? Sabi natin, pagka ang isang scenario or a situation wherein ang income in the books is higher than the taxable income, no, for the BIR, ito ay taxable temporary difference which will give rise to deferred tax liability, no? Mas mataas kasi ang income ng books kaysa sa tax authority here. Mas malaki ang kinlaim nila na deduction sa depreciation, no? Mas mataas ang deduction nila ng 500,000. So, mas mababa ang income naman nila ng 500,000, no? On the basis of this depreciation, on the basis of depreciation. Next, clearing amount of depreciable asset in excess of tax basis. So, is this included? No, it is no longer included because ang depreciation na nga ang ating naging basis, no? And this is very much related to the, no, ito di what we call expense, no, na depreciation, no, claim on the tax return in excess of financial depreciation. Okay, next, warranty expense reported on the income statement, no? Again, Ang tendency naman nito, no, the income of the books will tend to go down because nag-recognize sila ng warranty expense, samantalang ang actual naman, ano, let's go straight below, ay 20 or 50,000 lamang ang actual, samantalang dini-clear nila as deduction ay 200. So ang tendency nito ay mas mababa, basing on this particular item only, mas mababa ang kanilang income ng 150 because they claim, no, 200,000 as deduction, no, as expense, samantalang ang actual talaga na na-recognize ng BIR 50 lang. So mas mababa ang kanilang recognition ng income basing on this particular item ng 150. So to recap ang ating mga items, 97, no, to be deducted by 300,000, which is a permanent difference, no, it is not included in the taxable income for this particular problem, ano, it because siya ay tax exempt. Then the depreciation claim in excess that will give rise to taxable temporary difference, and this will lead to a deferred tax liability, no, deferred tax liability ay ang ating tax rate ay 30%. So ang ating ngayong tax liability na 500,000, no, ay mababawasan, ano, no, because we will try to get the difference between the tax liability, or shall we say tax liability, versus naman sa tax asset, kasi ang tax asset naman natin, because mas mababa nga ang ating reported income, no, pagdating dito sa warranty expense, no, 150. So ang magiging difference nito, no, wherein mataas ang income ng 500 at dito naman mababa ang income as far as the books is concerned ng 150. So ang net effect nito ay 350,000. So ang mangyayari, meron kang 350,000 na net, or shall we say ang ating deferred, no, shall we say na deferred tax expense ay 150, no, that is the excess of tax liability over the tax asset na 150. Okay, so let's try to finish. Sabi nga dito may 90,000 daw na beginning, so ganito ang ating bibigay sa inyo na information and techniques, ano. Meron kang tax liability at the beginning at wala ka namang deferred tax assets sa beginning, zero. Okay, let's answer the question now. What is the current tax expense of the current year? So ang current tax expense nito ay yung taxable income. Yun yung base sa BIR. Ganito yan, ha. I hope you will follow. 9.7 minus 300. That is 9.4. Okay? So, ang gagawin natin, we will continue the adjustment here. Kasi nakuha na natin yung taxable income eh, no, 9.4. Excuse me. So, ang mangyayari eh, since this is income declared in the books, no, 9.4 na ngayon ang taxable income, we have to deduct the 500, no? Deduct the 500 kasi part yan ng temporary differences. Now, we are trying to reconcile eh, no, para makuha natin yung taxable income for BIR. So, 9.4, no, and minus 500,000. Then yung tax asset naman natin ano mas ma taas naman ang income na dineclare ng BIR ng 150 plus 150,000 na ngayon tayo. So that is 9,050,000 eh, ang tax rate natin ay 30%. So times 30%. So, ang ating current tax expense ay letter A, 2,715,000. Yon ang current tax expense. Kung ano yung tax na sisingilin sa atin ng BIR, yon ang current tax expense. That is 2,715,000. No? Ulitin natin, 9.7 minus 300. No, plus or shall we say minus 500,000 and plus 150,000 multiplied by 30%. So yon ang ating current tax expense. So now we will go straight sa baba na what is the total tax expense. Ito ngayon ang answer. That is 9.7 minus the permanent difference na 300,000, that is 9.4. Yan. Yan ang ating financial taxable income, no, sa ating libro. So that is multiplied by 30%, that is 2,820,000. Again, that is 9.4 times 0.30 and that is 2,820,000. Okay. What is the total tax expense? The total tax expense is the current tax expense plus the deferred tax liability, or we can go straight ano doon sa ating taxable income based sa ating books. That is 9.7 minus 300,000 multiplied by 30%. That is the total tax expense of 2,820,000. Next, what is a deferred tax liability at year end? So ang deferred tax liability natin ay ang ating temporary or taxable temporary difference ay 500,000, ano? 'Yon ang ating ni-report multiplied by 30%, that is 150,000. So, we would like to clear that up, no? No, itong ating deferred tax liability at the beginning, no, ay not included. As far as answering this deferred tax liability at year end, no. Yun ang question eh. Kung anong deferred tax liability at year end. So, yun yung kung ano yung mga items affected doon sa computation ng deferred tax liability, yun ang lalabas na answer for the question ng deferred tax liability. It will be used on a separate question, no? Inuulit natin, separate question yan. Dito, to answer the deferred tax liability, that is 500,000 times 30%, that is 150,000, no? Cumulative yan, eh, no? Okay, what is the deferred tax asset at year end? Sabi kasi dito, no, wala tayong issue dahil zero naman ang deferred tax asset. Pero, paano natin makukuha yung deferred tax asset? That is 200,000 minus 50,000. That is, the deferred tax asset is 150,000 multiplied by 30%. That is 45,000. Again, the difference between 250, that is 150,000, ano, yon ang ating deferred tax asset. Okay? Multiplied by 30%, that will be 45,000 pesos. Yan ang deferred tax asset. Okay? So, again, yung sinasabi ko kanina na 90,000, gagamitin mo yan pag ang tinatanong ay deferred tax expense. Ang gagawin natin, yung changes nito, no, pagbabanggain natin yung changes ng deferred tax liability tsaka changes ng deferred tax asset, yon ang kukunin natin ng difference, no? Now, ano ang changes ng deferred tax liability? That is 150,000 minus 90,000. So ang change niya, no, nag-change ang deferred tax liability mo ng 60,000. No, please take that as a note sa inyo, no, na ang difference ng deferred tax liability ay 60,000. That is, ang recognize natin 150 minus 90, 60. Ano naman ang difference ng deferred tax asset? That is 0 naging 45,000 ang deferred tax asset. So, ang mangyayari, meron ka ngayong difference sa tax liability na 60, meron ka naman difference sa tax asset na 45. So, ano ang tunay na amount for deferred tax expense? That will answer the deferred tax expense. That is 60,000, yung difference ng 90 and 150, minus 45, that is 15,000. That will answer the deferred tax expense. No? Again, ano, i-wrap up natin ang ating current tax expense, that is the income tax expense as far as taxable income is concerned, 2,715. Ano naman ang total tax expense? This is the tax expense, no, as far as the financial accounting income, financial income is concerned, that is 2,820,000. Okay, what is the deferred tax liability? Ito yung mga temporary differences that made the income per books higher than the income per BIR, no? Ang nakuha natin ay 150, no? That is 500,000 times 30%. So, ano naman ang ating deferred tax asset? That is the answer for 150,000, no? Kasi 150,000 ang deferred tax, ang ating deductible temporary difference, eh. Deductible temporary difference, that is 150 multiplied by 30%, that is 45,000. At again, yung last na binanggit ko, yung difference ng change ng taxable liability or deferred tax liability, yung change niya, that is 150, where is that? 150 minus 90, that is 60. Yun ang change ng deferred tax liability ng ating taxable temporary difference, ano? That is, or shall we say, deferred tax liability, sorry. Ang change niya ay 60,000. At ibangga natin yung change ng deferred tax asset na 45. Ang answer ay 15. Pero, what is that 15? That is a deferred tax expense. Yon ang answer doon. Okay? So, again, as I always say, this is just a quick review lang, ano? And I hope this will help you sa mga kumukuha ng accounting. So, para wag maging overwhelming, ano? Let's just simply go out, shall we say, exit, no, by saying a positive note. So keep safe and study hard and keep accounting as enjoyable, no, as interesting, no, as it is really is, no, interesting and enjoyable topic. So bye for now. See you for the next video.